Huh? Hello, Father. I brought Mother's necklace back from the lair of the beast for you. But it is broken.
You did what? Foolish child! You... You could have been killed. And then where would I be, without you, my most treasured possession?
But you said that Mother's necklace was your most treasured possession.
I said it, but I did not mean it. How could I? Don't you see? I did not trust the monster, so I said a lie. I lied because I wanted to protect you.
Really? I thought you did not care about me. I'm so sorry. You must have been so worried.
To think it was all but a misunderstanding. If only he and his father had simply been honest with one another.
Yes, if only. I'll see you both outside, okay?
Ah, Father, these are my new friends. They are the ones who rescued everybody.
Oh.
I cannot thank you enough. You are true heroes. The first time we met, when you rescued me, I was searching for Son. But I had to pretend that I did not care, in case the monster came back and realized that I had lied. I hope you understand.
Where's my friend with the feathers? I wanted to say thank you.
Silvando left Frey suddenly. Perhaps we should go and look for him.
He and his father had simply been honest with one another.
Ah, you scared me! How long have you been standing there? Ah, never mind. It was nice to see Son reunited with his father, huh? But there are some who will never be reunited with their loved ones. Some bridges that will never be repaired. Can I ask you something? Morthegon he's super powerful, right? Powerful enough to destroy our world. You've seen that power for yourself, but you still want to fight him, don't you? No, stop it, you. I know you're more determined than ever to take him down. You really are a hero, huh? You know, I thought it was enough. Traveling the world, trying to put smiles back on people's faces. But what good is a smile here and there if the Lord of Shadows could snatch it away at any moment? What I'm saying is, I have to leave my beloved parade and come with you. It's the only way. But there's something I want you to help me with first. It's all well and good me going and getting my head squished by Morthegon, but I can't do that to my darling boys.
So we have to leave them somewhere safe, with somebody who can look after them. Now, I know just the place and just the person, but... Well, there's no good way of saying this. I'm petrified of seeing him. So you have to come with me. You will, won't you, darling? Oh, thank you. I knew you'd say yes. Okay, I'm going to go break the news to my little soldiers of Smile. I have an announcement to make. My parading days are over.
No!
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 But do not fear. It will only be for a little while. I will return as soon as the Lord of Shadows is defeated.
We understand, Sylve. That Mordigan's stolen enough smiles. Someone's got to stop him.
Yeah, you go and do what you gotta do, Sylve. We'll be heartbroken without you, of course, but we'll survive. And if anyone can show that rotten spoilsport what's what, it's you.
Exactly. We'll never get those smiles back if I don't do this. And I won't be leaving you high and dry. I'm going to ask my papi to look after you in Puerto Valor.
Puerto Valor? Wait. Surely not. Surely you cannot be Don Rodrigo's...
So you finally figured it out, huh? Same old stone-headed Hendrik. Such a sweet, simple boy.
Ah! All right, my little champions of cheer. Let's go show Puerto Valor how to party! Yeah!
I cannot fathom it. The boy is unrecognizable, and he has abandoned the name his father gave him. Don Rodrigo must be furious. Forgive me for my lack of composure. This has all come as quite a shock. Silvando is none other than the son and heir of Don Rodrigo, the noblest and most revered of all knights. It was always assumed that he would follow in his father's footsteps. But the two had a terrible argument, and the boy left Puerto Valor, never to return. Until now. But perhaps this is not such a bad thing. Very well. It is not far from here to Puerto Valor.
Thank you.
so strange. I thought I'd never see this place again, and yet here I am. Well, at least I came back with a bang. You go on ahead, honey. I need a second to compose myself.
Don Rodrigo, it is I, Hendrik. It has been too long.
Hendrik? Ho, ho, ho! How many years has it been since you completed your training, eh? Come closer, caballero. Let me see your face. I have heard many tales of your exploits. To think that the great lump of meat who came to me all those years ago is now the hero of Eliador.
I had not expected to find you in such good spirits, my lord. As one who owes everything to your kind offices, it pleases me greatly. Alas, there has been precious little cause for mirth since last we met. Don Rodrigo and I have much to discuss. Perhaps you could go and fetch Silvando while we talk.
Hey, honey. I guess they sent you to fetch me, huh? It's so silly, I know. Here I am, happy to go put my neck on the line in the fight against the Lord of Shadows. And yet, the thought of facing Papi makes me want to run away screaming. Seeing that boy and his father in Phnomnon made me think I could do it. That I could finally face him. But now I'm here, I'm so scared. You've heard what happened with me and him, I guess. Hendrik told you, huh? It all seems so far away now. Even before I could walk, I was training to be a knight, you know? I would stay in Puerto Valor and follow in my father's footsteps. Then one day, the circus came to town. It was so, so fabulous. I can't even describe it. It was love at first sight. I knew from the second I walked into that tent that I'd found my calling. But Papi, he wasn't so keen. A few plates got smashed the night I broke the news to him, let me tell you. But I wasn't going to let that stop me. Oh no. This was my calling, to make the whole world happy. I would be a knight in smiling armor.
You didn't have anything to say to me after that. That was when I knew that I had to go and prove to him that I meant what I said. So I left. And I haven't seen him since. Ah, dear me, that got a bit long and emotional, huh? But it's made me feel a whole lot better. In fact, yes, let's do this.
It's now or never. Let's go pay Papi a visit. Hi, puppy!
Caramba! Norberto, you dare to show your face in my presence! And you have come to tell me something, see?
I'm sorry, puppy! Sorry! So sorry!
Sorry? What are you apologizing for, foolish boy?
Huh?
You have succeeded in making the world smile, see?
Not yet, Papi.
Then why are you here, hmm? Why did you come back if you have not yet done as you promised? You said you would do it, Norberto. You said you would make everyone happy. I did not raise you to be a failure. How dare you come to me and...
Puppy!
Damn you, boy. If I were younger, I would put you over my knee.
Wait. Puppy, did you say knight? You still think of me as one? Oh, you have no idea how... Oh, thank you, Puppy. Thank you. I guess it wasn't very knightly of me to come back before I'd fulfilled my promise, huh? But I had a good reason.
Lord of Shadows. See?
See. How can I make people happy if he is there making their lives miserable? It is impossible. Which is why I'm going to beat him. Only then can I fulfill my vow and make all the people of the world smile again.
Careful, boy! Do not promise to defeat Mordegon if you do not truly intend to do so. I will not have you break another oath.
Of course, Papi. A knight's word is his bond. You taught me that. But there's just one teensy-weensy little thing I need to ask you to do to help. I've picked up a few friends on my travels. They're kind of young and kind of innocent. They need a role model, you know? Someone to lead them.
You do not even need to ask, Norberto.
Oh, Papi, really?
Come on, Norberto! Of course, it will be my pleasure.
Oh, aren't you just the sweetest, kindest father a boy could hope to have?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, darlings! Come say hello to your tío Rodrigo!
Oh, what a lovely bedroom. It's so big. Oh, don't tell me this is your dad, Sylv. He's awfully manly. I'll feel safe with you looking after me, Mr. Rodrigo.
Norberto, explain yourself. What is the meaning of this?
Now, Papi, let's just pop this on.
Oh. Hey, Norberto, where are you? Hey, get your hands off of me! Curse your foolishness, boy! I did not agree to this!
Oh, don't be like that, Papi. How can you lead my little band of boys if you don't look the part, huh? You promised. And didn't you always teach me that a knight's word is his bond? Listen to me, soldiers of Smile. You serve my papi now. You must do as he says. Do not fail me.
Please, Sylv, don't go. Don't leave us.
Darlings, it breaks my heart to say goodbye. Truly, it does. But we have to be strong. As soon as Mordegon is defeated, I'll be right back with you.
And no matter how far I go, no matter how hard it gets, I'll always be with you. Always.
Oh, Sylv, we'll be with you too. Just say the word and we'll come running.
Thanks so much for all your help, darling. I'm all yours now, I promise.
The salty stallion is all yours too, of course. She's anchored off to the east of here.
With a ship at our disposal, other places will be accessible to us. Perhaps now we can seek out your friends in Arborea.
For the old dog yet.
Fabulous, darling.
Stormy all of a sudden.
Silvando, this ship of yours is not about to sink, is it?
Don't mention the S word! I'll have us out of this in just a jiffy!
Fresh flesh!
That voice, where is it coming from?
Servant of the Lord of Shadows and ruler of the deep. You dare to enter my realm unbidden. Know that an insult to me is an insult to my Lord and Master.
The one who'll be paying you, great big slimy so-and-so. Get a load of this!
Are you having me on? I just blasted you with pearly gates and you barely even flinched!
The awe with which my lord and master entrusted me renders all your petty human enchantments null and void. Now join me in the blackest depths of despair.
And what, might I ask, are you staring at? Is there something stuck to my face? All right, all right. It is rather an imposing appearance, I agree. Why don't we try another? No, still no good.
Not settling on a particular form, hmm?
That rather makes me think you might not know who I am. In your world, I am known as the Seer. I take on different appearances for different people, you see. By which I mean to say that I look different depending on who is doing the looking. But enough about me. How's the fishing? Caught anything? You're a terrible liar, you know. You're not ready yet, you see. When the time comes, you will know it. When the fish finally takes the bait, you must be ready to reel it in. You know, I have the strangest feeling I've met one of your companions. Eric, was it? Well, no matter. We are not here to discuss him. Come, let us go inside. Take a seat. Make yourself at home. Now, the fact that you're here makes me wonder if you might have taken a bit of a wrong turn somewhere. Ah, so that's it. Worried we've lost the power of the luminary, are we? Well, I'm afraid there's not much I can do about that. But there is one thing I can say. You may think that your power has been taken from you by the Lord of Shadows, but power cannot be taken, no more than it can be touched or tasted, especially not the power of the Luminary. Still no idea of what I'm talking about, huh? Well, no matter. Let me leave you with this thought. When the time comes, you will know. Oh, that's right. You're drowning, aren't you? That won't do at all. Well, don't fret. A certain sacred tree tells me it's not your time just yet. Right. We'd better get you woken up, hadn't we? Go. Save the world.
Darling, you're alive! Oh, thank goodness!
When you took that tumble into the sea back there, we all thought you were done for, laddie. Oh, it was terrible. But then, well, it was nothing short of a miracle. There was a bright light, and suddenly, there you were, floating up from the seabed. Somehow we managed to pull you out of the water, give that big slimy so-and-so the slip, and get here to safety. I still don't know quite how we did it.
What's the matter, honey?
You look like you've seen a ghost.
You're kidding. You were fishing, and you met a person called the Seer, and they turned into a dog?
Oh, come on, silly Billy. You were just dreaming, that's all.
You have been through quite an ordeal. You need rest.
Mm-hmm. Whoop!
Put courage in your heart and lightning in your hand.
Time enough for staring out to sea tomorrow, laddie.